And welcome back to day two of our Party Time Holiday Bible Club. We're so pleased that you could come back again for this second day. And we've got even more craft and drama and story and Bible verse and songs for you to enjoy and have fun with. And hopefully by looking around today, you might be able to work out what today's theme is. Well, it's a wedding party theme today. And I've just got a few things that you might find linked to a wedding. So we've got obviously some congratulations banners, because you would say that to the happy couple. Some bunting, got a wedding present, invitation of course, confetti to throw over the bride, a place name for at the reception, and some party poppers for the celebration too. So, and we're going to hear about a wedding in our story today. But first, we're going to sing our theme song again. It's Party Time. And this here's just a little reminder of the actions in the chorus. So it goes like this. Come on, everyone, stamp your feet and join the fun. Jump around, dance and sing, come on, it's party time. So here's our theme song, enjoy singing it and dance around and have fun.
Party. Oh, I'm so excited. Quick, I must send him a message. Oh, I must let him know I'm coming. Jeffrey. Oh, party!
Oh. Oh, great! Amelia can come to the party!
Well, I suppose I could go to Jeffrey's party. It's not like I've got anything else to do. Just hope it's not too boring. Guess I'd better tell him that I'm coming then. To Jeffrey, yes, I'll come. There, that'll do. I don't want to sound too keen.
Great, another reply. Matilda can come too.
I need to reply to Jeffrey. What should I say? Does he really want me to go to this party? I think I'll go. Or should I not? I mean, I don't have any other plans. I've decided I'll go. I hope this is okay. Better tell Jeffrey. To Jeffrey. I'd like to go to the party. Only if it's not too much trouble. Don't want to be a bother. I hope this is okay. From Jemima.
Another text. I wonder who could this could be from. It's from Jemima. I was hoping she could come. And she can! Great!
Well, of course I'm going to Jeffrey's party. It wouldn't be a party without me, because I am so much fun. I better DM Jeffrey. Sup, Jeff. I'm cool for hanging out at your party at your crib. Peace, Simon.
Another message. I think that's a yes from Simon.
But what am I going to wear?
But what am I going to wear?
But what am I going to wear?
What am I going to wear, dude?
Myself. I thought I was here alone with a snoring dog. do you know, I've got a question. Have you been invited to Jeffrey's party? I forgot his name.
Oh, of course I have. Jeffrey obviously wanted to have a really cool party, which is why he invited me. To be honest, I was only hoping he had invited me.
Well, I'm going too. Do you know, it's going to be so amazing. I'm so excited. I can't wait. It's going to be brilliant. I'm really pleased you're going. I'm really pleased. Is that right, Poppy? Oh, Jemima.
Hello? Am I on the right call? I don't want to intrude.
Hi. It's so lovely to see you. Are you going to Jeffrey's party?
I am. I'm hoping it's okay. I don't want to get in the way.
Well, he wouldn't have invited you otherwise. Of course he wants you there. You're not going to be in the way.
Maybe. We'll see.
Oh, Matilda! Hi! Oh, it's so good to see you. I haven't seen you for ages. How are things?
I'm okay. Not really done much lately. I mean, life's pretty boring, really.
Well, Jeffrey's party is not going to be boring. You are going, aren't you? You are going.
Well, I suppose so. I've got nothing better to do.
It's going to be great. Okay, now, the reason I've got you all here today is because I've got this really massive dilemma and Poppy can't help me with it. I've got this terrible dilemma. I just don't know what to wear to the party. It's awful. What do I wear? What do I wear? Has anybody got any ideas?
Well, personally, I'm going to wear my old baggy football t-shirt. It might still have a little bit of dirt on from when I fell off my skateboard while doing a really, really cool trick. It made me look awesome, but I'm sure I'll be fine.
Doesn't the invite say you had to wear your best clean clothes?
So what? Clean, dirty? Whatever I wear is always really cool.
Well, I was going to wear my blue skirt. I only washed it the other day because I was bored. So, it's definitely clean.
I'm going to wear my best jumper. I hope it'll be okay for the party.
Okay. Okay, great. Do you know what? You have all given me loads of ideas. I think I know what I'm going to wear now.
Oh, what?
Well, I'm not going to tell you, am I? It's a surprise. I can't tell you. You have to wait to find out at the party. It's going to be ace. I'll see you there. Bye!
Bye!
Bye.
I can't believe those guys going to the party. They are nowhere near as cool as me. And if they go, the party won't be cool anymore. I know! I'll send them a new invitation saying that the party is at Eleanor's house instead. I am such a genius. This is such a clever plan. To Amelia. There's been a change of plan. The party will now be at Eleanor's house instead. From Jeffrey.
Does Amelia really know what she's going to wear to the party? Will Matilda ever stop feeling bored? Will Jemima ever stop saying, "I hope it's okay"? Will Jeffrey get everything ready in time for the party? Will Simon's plan really work? Find out tomorrow in part 3 of Party Time.
Wow, can you believe Simon's plan? I really hope they all get to go to the party. You'll have to come back tomorrow to find out what happens next in our drama. But for now, we're going to sing another song, and this might be a new song to you, and it's called All About Jesus. And this song tells us that all of the Bible is all about Jesus. And after this song, we're going to have our Bible story for today.
Out by you, your spirit wrote through men like a pen in the hand of a God who knew that we would need to know how much you love us. So you wrote it down for us forever. Oh, oh, from Genesis to Revelation, there's one story of your great salvation. It's all about Jesus. Oh, it's all about Jesus. Shout now. So bright, it leads us day by day to the one, the way, the truth, the light. And every time we read, you give us what we need to grow in grace and know you better. Oh, oh, from Genesis to Revelation, there's one story of your great salvation.
about Jesus. Even from Eden we read, the serpent will be crushed by a seed of Eve. Cause all glory belongs to the Son. Every story pointing to the Holy One. Like when Abraham put Isaac on the altar, he pulled the knife, but God, he never falters. Faithful to his promise, he would provide a substitute ram for the sacrifice. And now, he gave commandments so we could see his holiness and our desperate need. There were so many temporary sacrifices, none of them were perfect, no, but Christ is. The prophet spoke and they were not liars. God would send his very own Son to be Messiah. Rescue, redeem, restore, reclaim. Every saint loves his holy name. Cause he died on the cross to take our place, the final substitute and eternal grace. And he rose from the grave and up to the throne, until he comes again to gather his own.
From Genesis to Revelation, there's one story of your great salvation. It's all about Jesus, yo. It's all about Jesus. Shout now from every page, there's one hero that'll save the day. It's all about Jesus, yo. It's all about Jesus.
My name's Helen, and I would really love to share a story with you today. And this is going to be a story that you would find in the Bible. If you were to have a Bible and you were to look through the Bible, you would find a book of the Bible called John. And this is John chapter 2, verses 1 to 11. And it's actually the very first miracle that Jesus ever performed. Let's find out what happened. Now, Jesus had been invited to a wedding. I wonder if you've ever been to a wedding. They're really happy. They're a really jolly occasion where lots of people go and they like to enjoy time with their friends. Maybe they meet some new people they've not met before, but they certainly like to have a dance. They love to have fun with their friends, chattering away, maybe having a little sing-song to some music. There is always lots of lovely food to enjoy. And they were enjoying lovely food at the wedding. And they were enjoying lots of things to drink. And they were having a really fantastic time. They really were. It was lovely. And they enjoyed the day. And then, suddenly, ah! What? There's no wine! What? There's no wine? What? They've run out of wine? The wedding has... They've run out of wine at the wedding? This is bad news. Can you imagine going to a wedding and they run out of wine? There's nothing for people to drink. That's like going to a birthday party and they've run out of cake. Imagine being at a birthday party with no cake. That would just be wrong. Now, Jesus's mum was at this wedding with him. And she was thinking to herself, and she turned to Jesus and she said, Jesus, is there nothing that you can do? Is there nothing that you could do to help the people at the wedding? Now, Jesus, as we know, was quite incredible. And his mum had asked him, and so he thought, and he came up with a plan. He looked around and he spotted that there were some servants, and there were some servants standing next to some really big, heavy jugs. Now, these jugs were usually used for filling with water. And he said to the servants, can you go and fill those jugs? Fill up those jugs with water. Fill them to the top. And there were six massive, massive, pretend it's massive, massive jugs. So they struggled. And they were worked as a team and they filled the jugs with water all the way to the top. And then they looked at each other. Well, how does this help? Because the problem is we've got no wine. We've got plenty of water, but we've got no wine, Jesus, no wine. And he said, don't worry. What I would like you to do is take those jugs of water and go to the master of the wedding. Now, you know he's the master because he's wearing a terribly serious hat. The master of the wedding was sitting with his empty wine glass at the table at the wedding. And the servants came over and Jesus said, go and pour him some of the water from the jug. Okay, I don't think he's going to be very happy about it, but okay. So they poured. And as they poured, they came to realise it was no longer water, but it was wine. How did Jesus do that? He had turned water into wine. Now, the terribly important man who was seated at the wedding, he was the master of the wedding. He was the leader of the banquet. He took his glass and he said, oh, this smells delicious. Oh, never before have I been to a wedding where the very finest wine has been served at the end. Normally you save the cheapest stuff to last, but not at this wedding. And he called over the bride and groom and he wanted to congratulate them and say thank you for being such generous hosts. And they looked a little bit confused. And then they realised that Jesus had done something incredible. And that made them amazed. Now, this might seem like a strange thing for Jesus to have done. But actually, there is a reason he had done this. And we can learn from this story. But what can we learn from this story? We can learn that Jesus is to be trusted. We can believe in Jesus and we can trust what we read about him in the Bible. He was an incredible man. He saw these people were in need. He didn't want the wedding to be spoilt, and so he helped. But how can we believe and trust in Jesus? How can we do that? Well, we can accept, we can know that it is true that Jesus is who he says he is. Jesus is incredible. I don't know anybody that can turn water into wine, especially not the finest wine ever tasted. It is true that Jesus is who he says he is. He is the Son of God. Nobody else can do such things. Nobody else can perform miracles. But why should we believe this? Why should we believe that Jesus is the Son of God? Well, just as Jesus changed the water into wine, just as Jesus gave the wedding party a new lease of life, he can give us new life. He can give us, more importantly, a changed life. He can give us a life that is forever, a life that is eternal, a life that is with him. And he can do this because he is God's Son. No one else can do that. Nobody else can turn water into wine. And nobody else can claim to be the Son of God. So let's trust him and know that he loves us. Thank you for listening to this story. I hope to see you soon. Goodbye.
Hello, my name's Katie and I'm going to teach you the memory verse for today. We've just heard the amazing story of how when Jesus was at a wedding, he turned normal, plain old water into the best wine ever. And do you know why Jesus did that? Well, our memory verse today tells us. He did this to reveal his glory. That means to show his glory, to show everyone who he is, to show that he's the Son of God who is powerful and can do miracles. Now, I can't do miracles, but I've learned a clever little trick, which I'm going to use to show you today's memory verse. Okay, here goes. I'm going to take a little bit of water and reveal to you the memory verse. What Jesus did here revealed his glory. John chapter 2, verse 11. Pretty clever, eh? So that is our memory verse today. What Jesus did here revealed his glory. John chapter 2, verse 11. John is the book in the Bible where you can find this verse. And it is the second chapter, chapter 2, and the 11th verse, verse 11. So if you have a Bible at home, you could have a go at looking it up. Let's say it again together. What Jesus did here revealed his glory. John chapter 2, verse 11. If you do look up the verse in your Bible, you'll notice that there are some extra words in there as well. So if you fancy a little challenge, maybe for you older ones or for those who've got really good memory, you could try and remember a little bit more of the verse. The extra details in the verse tell you that it was the very first miracle that Jesus ever did. And it also tells you where it happened. Can you remember where the wedding was? That's right, in Cana of Galilee. So the longer version you could learn is, what Jesus did here in Cana of Galilee was the first of the signs through which he revealed his glory. John chapter 2, verse 11. Let's say this longer verse again together. What Jesus did here in Cana of Galilee was the first of the signs through which he revealed his glory. John chapter 2, verse 11. Okay, so let's go back to this shorter version and see how well you can remember it. I'm going to cover up a word and see if you can still tell me what it says. What Jesus did here revealed his glory. John chapter 2, verse 11. You join in at home. What Jesus did here revealed his glory. John chapter 2, verse 11. How about now? What Jesus did here revealed his glory. John chapter 2, verse 11. Getting trickier. What Jesus did here revealed his glory. John chapter 2, verse 11. What Jesus did here revealed his glory. John chapter 2, verse 11. How about now? Can you say it without any of the words? What Jesus did here revealed his glory. John chapter 2, verse 11. Well done. So if you want to show us how well you've remembered that verse, join us again on the Zoom call at 5 o'clock later today. See you then. Bye.
Hello. Welcome to day 2 of Party Time Holiday Bible Club Craft. Today is the wedding party, so we have the congratulations banner up for the bride and groom. This is a special wedding because Jesus was there and he did his first miracle when he turned water into wine. So our craft today is making this. And you can see a jug here pouring wine into the cup. So we're going to make this slidey painted picture. Here, what you'll need are some templates that can be downloaded off the website, and they need to be printed onto card so you can get one of your parents or your guardian to help you with that. And the first thing that we need to do is to cut out this hole here. So I needed a sharp spiky thing and we're going to puncture a hole in the middle, like that. Then you're going to get the scissors and carefully cut out this bit which is where the wine is going to pour. You can leave a bit in the glass so that you just have the bit that you're pouring out that is cut out. Like that, you can see through. And then with the tab that is going to go behind your picture, cut that bit out. And we're just going to place that behind the jug so that you can see it covers the hole, and you've got this little tab that sticks out at the end. Next, you're going to need a pencil, and you're just going to draw around the inside here. This is just to help you when we get on to painting. And of course, if we're painting, we need an apron or a lovely paint shirt like I've got here, so that we don't get our clothes dirty. There we go. This one even smells of paint. So I'm going to take this one off, and I'm going to start with my jug and my cup. And I'm going to have a lovely brown colour, like clay, for my pot, my jug. And you can be as creative as you like with your painting. You can decorate it however you like, and probably be a bit neater than I am, keeping in the edges. We've got a mat on the table here, so it doesn't matter if I get any through the hole. So there's my jug, and I'm gonna do some red for the wine. Maybe you want to do a more purpley red. Well, I'm going bright red for my wine, because although we call them red grapes, it does look a bit purpley sometimes. So I'm going to colour in my drink, and the splashes it makes. I need a small brush for that one. And I'm going to do my cup purple, because purple's my favourite colour. This probably would have been the Master of the Banquets cup, because he tasted the wine before it went to all the guests. And this wine that Jesus made, he said, tasted even better than the wine that came before, because it was a miracle when Jesus made the wine. It was the best wine. Okie dokie. So then we can leave this bit to dry, and we'll paint the tab that's going to go behind it for the wine that's going to be pouring down. So you can see that we've got the outline here where the gap is, and we don't want to paint in that gap or to the right of that gap. So we're only going to paint over here, and I'm going to do it a bit wavy as it's falling down. So again, I'm just going to use the colour that I poured into my glass. try and get it a bit closer to the pencil. I don't want to go over that pencil. And I'm going to add a bit of brown just to make the colour a bit more interesting. And mix it with my little brush and waves. And we're going to leave that one to dry as well. And while we're waiting for that to dry, with the card that you cut this one out of, there'll be lots of leftover card like this. And we're just going to cut two strips, about 2 centimetres wide, all the way down. Dried, we will come back and I'll show you how you can stick it to the back of your photo. These are the dry ones I did earlier. So once your paint has dried, you can get the tab and you're going to place it behind your picture where the window is, but you're going to keep going. And you're just going to stop just before the red paint comes out this side of your picture, so that you don't see that at all. And once you've got it to this position, hold it very still and flip it over. And this is when you'll need your strips of card that you cut earlier. And the first strip you're going to place just in front of this corner here, but try not to move the tab. You want it to stay there and it will hold it in place. So get your glue stick and glue above the tab here and below the tab, but don't put any glue in the middle because we still want the tab to be able to move left and right. And so we're going to stick that down. And again, your second one, I put it at the end here. Again, glue at the top and the bottom, but not in the middle. But try and get fairly close because we don't want the tab to be able to wiggle around too much. We just want it to go left and right. So there we go, once you've stuck it, that glue isn't sticking very well, but this one's stuck and you can see there's just a little gap in the middle there. And that means that we can push it from left to right. It goes nice and easy. So there we have it, that's my painting done. But if you've got some more time, I think you could maybe paint some pictures for some people at the wedding. Maybe some people dancing in the background, or the master of the banquet who tastes the wine. You could draw him here with a surprised face. And maybe if you want, you could do another slidey bit going up and down of his eyebrows, because I think that would be cool, showing how surprised he is. When we're surprised, our eyes open up
and our eyebrows go up. I think that'd be very cool. But if you don't have paint, you can use felt tips as well, or crayons. You can use glitter, decorate it however you like. There are other wedding crafts on the website too. And once you've done that, you can bring it to the Zoom session at 5 and show us what you've made. Because that would be very cool to see what each other have made. So this was the wedding, and it was the wedding at Cana. That was the place where they were. And if you remember, the memory verse was from John chapter 2 verse 11 in the Bible. And it says that what Jesus did here in Cana of the Galilee was the first of the signs that he did to reveal his glory. So it showed us that Jesus wasn't just a man. He did a miracle, and it showed us that he is the Son of God. Because we can't turn water into wine, can we? Well, I hope you enjoyed that craft, and hopefully see you later. Bye!
Well, that's it for day two of our Party Time Holiday Bible Club. I hope you've enjoyed our wedding party theme today. And we heard in our story today that Jesus did his first miracle, that he turned water into wine. And he did that to show something about himself. He did it to show us that Jesus is God's son. How amazing is that, that we've learned that today. So I hope to see some of you at 5 o'clock on Zoom, where you could come dressed up in your best clothes as if you were going to a wedding. And we're gonna have some more games, another quiz. I wonder who's gonna win today. We're going to have see the lovely craft you've made, and don't forget to come back tomorrow and join us for day three of our Party Time Holiday Bible Club. So see you then. Bye!